completely in half at the waist. She was on her back with her arms raised and her legs wide apart. Her face and body had been deeply slashed with a knife, and there were rope burns on her wrists and ankles. But no blood around the body. The murderer had evidently washed her clean after draining her blood. It was clear to LAPD detectives that she had been killed elsewhere, then dumped here. The cause of death was hemorrhage and shock due to concussion of the brain and lacerations of the face. Who was she? Her face was so badly slashed that the coroner had to sew it together. Her fingerprints were sent to the FBI on the off chance that they would be on file. They were, because of an arrest for underage drinking in Santa Barbara, California. Her name was Elizabeth Short, 22 years old. Elizabeth, or Beth, as she liked to be called, had a very striking look. Her hair was pure black, her skin very white, and she always wore bright red lipstick. She was like a flower, some said, and no one is quite sure when, but at some point, Beth became known as the Black Dahlia. From a small town in Massachusetts, Beth came to Vallejo, California, to live with her father when she was 19. But her father kicked her out because he thought she was too messy and too boy crazy. She went to stay with a girlfriend in Santa Barbara, and this is where she and a group of friends were arrested for drunken behavior in a restaurant. She was booked and fingerprinted and ordered to return to Massachusetts, which she did, but she didn't stay long. She came back to California, this time to Hollywood, hoping, as many pretty girls had before and after her, to get into the movies and become a star. From time to time, Beth was sidetracked from her goal with romance. Marriage was another dream, but nothing worked out. She was engaged to a pilot for a time, but he was killed in a crash in India. Then it all came to this. The police had the job of trying to reconstruct her last days and hours to see if it could lead to her killer. The last place she was seen alive was at the Biltmore Hotel, and after this she was missing for 6 days until she was found in the vacant lot. Eventually, after chasing leads that went nowhere, a prime suspect emerged. A tall, slender man with a pronounced limp, an alcoholic and sex pervert by the name of Jack Wilson. But he died in a fire caused by his own careless smoking before he could be questioned. To this day, however, the case is unsolved, and poor Elizabeth Short will be remembered as the Black Dahlia, the woman that was brutally murdered and cut in half. On June 15, 1947, a man was reading the Los Angeles Times in the living room of a posh Beverly Hills mansion. It was the end of a long day. Then about 10:30 p.m., his life came to an end, suddenly and very violently. He was Benjamin Siegel, known by the nickname Bugsy, which no one ever called him to his face if they knew what was good for them. Siegel was bad-tempered, a gangster, and a sociopath. He was born in 1906 in Brooklyn. At the age of 14, he ruled his own gang. By 21, he was guilty of mayhem, bootlegging, hijacking, drug dealing, white slavery, burglary, robbery, rape, bookmaking, extortion, and at least 12 murders. Bugsy had ties with other mobsters, such as Meyer Lansky, Lucky Luciano, Frank Costello, Albert Anastasia, and Al Capone. Sometime in the mid-1930s, Bugsy came to Hollywood to run the syndicate's operations on the West Coast. It's been said that Bugsy enjoyed killing, but he could be charming, and he was good-looking. He became a celebrity gangster, a prized guest at Hollywood parties, and he hobnobbed with movie stars, such as Cary Grant, Gene Harlow, George Raft, Clark Gable, and Gary Cooper, and many other celebrities. Then in the early 40s, Bugsy was said to have had a vision. one that foresaw the sleepy little gas-stop Nevada town of Las Vegas turning into a gambling paradise. That this was Bugsy's vision has been disputed. The facts are that another man, a Billy Wilkerson, started the construction on the Flamingo Hotel, the first luxury hotel and gambling casino in Las Vegas. But when his money dried up, Bugsy, with $6 million of New York mob money, completed the hotel. And it opened in Hollywood, lavish style, on New Year's Eve in 1946.